Hi, everybody. Don Taylor here. Welcome to this post-game edition of Connected as the Canucks knock off the Phoenix Coyotes 2-1. Don Taylor along with Gary Volk. And Gary, the big story going into this game was Canucks' injuries. At the end of the night, they ended up overcoming those injuries.
Well, they did, and thanks in large part to what Scotty Arneal does in Chicago. We mentioned it in the pregame show. Guys like Jordan Schrader, look, he stepped in and played a whale of a game.
Chris Tanev also scored.
Gordon played a whale of a game. Right. So, yeah, the Wolves did their job.
Let's hit the highlights. Canucks, Coyotes, Andrew Gordon. Gary just mentioned him making his Canucks debut wearing Rob Murphy's old number 44, by the way. Steve Pizzotto had the flu. Zach Cassian with a bad back. Chris Higgins with the bad back. There's Gordon making a check. Later on, Antoine Vermette on a break. But Mason Raymond hard on the back check, breaks up the play. And the play continues, and would you look at this? The guy who made the nice defensive play, setting up Chris Tanev. Raymond to Tanev, past Mike Smith. Tanev second, 1-0 Van. Keith Ballard moving up to the wing for this game with all the injuries. First period still. Ballard on the rush. Backhand shot goes off Smith and just gets a piece of the post. It stays 1-0 after one period of play. Ballard didn't look out of place up front. He's a great skater. Second period, Daniel Sedin drives the net, loses the puck, and crashes into Mike Smith. Daniel was cut. He would go to the dressing room. You know, we still hear people say that Sedins aren't tough. He would later return. Now, Smith was also shaken up. He stayed in the game, at least temporarily. Both Sedins getting banged around, still in the second. Henrik drilled by Rob Klinkhammer. He laid the Klinkhammer on Henrik. Late second, Alex Edler drills Smith behind the net. A brouhaha ensues, as you would expect. Edler would get a five-minute major for charging. This is just my opinion. I thought he was trying to avoid Smith. After a rough second, Dan Hamm, he was getting repairs and having blood cleaned off his jersey. He stayed 1-0 after two. Jason LaBarber takes over for Smith to start the third. Coyotes power play. Redeem bought a shot, hits the crossbar, but Vermette into the yawning cage, ties it at one. His seventh mid-frame. Yannick Hansen, who had another strong game, puts the puck on net. LaBarber can't handle the shot. Jordan Schrader's there for the rebound. Schrader, too, had a strong game. Gary just talked about it. Vancouver over Phoenix, 2-1. The Canucks have now won four of their last six games. Coyotes have lost five straight. They scored just three goals in those five games, and 7 of 9 as the Canucks snap a three-game losing streak versus the Phoenix Coyotes. Shots on goal, Phoenix 34, Vancouver 32. Corey Schneider played very well. In the Northwest Division now, the Canucks get the victory. They are tied with the Minnesota Wild on top of the Northwest Division in terms of points, but Minnesota gets first place as a result of more wins. You saw Jordan Schrader get the winning goal. Here he is back in Phoenix with Murph.
Canucks win 2-1 in Phoenix, and Jordan, you guys knew it was going to be tough tonight with so many players out. No Higgins, no Cassian, no Pizzotto. All guys were in the lineup a couple of nights ago, but how did you get through this one to win?
Yeah, I think we played a good structure. We got pucks in behind the D and got some timely goals. That helped.
You went down, came back up, and it seems like offensively you're playing with a little more confidence after just a couple of games in Chicago.
That's got to be my game, playing with confidence. Moving the puck and using my offensive abilities, but being responsible defensively. So I wanted to come up here and do that.
You had a chance just before you scored that goal, shot of wide, but persevered.
Yeah, I got had a little gift in front that I think he actually, I don't know if he got a piece of it or what, but I was fortunate enough to get a bounce back.
Congratulations on the goal and the win.
Thanks, appreciate it.
All right, Jordan Schrader has the game winner. Let's go upstairs to John and John.
Well, Murph, the Canucks, as you mentioned, had a number of players kind of filling in, you had to say, a lot of absences in the lineup. But when that happens, you want them to do well, but you know your goaltender is going to have to be your best player maybe. And Corey Schneider, another strong performance, 32 saves, John, and only the one goal against to get the win.
Well, I thought the Canucks played a good, smart road period in the first period. The shots were 8-5, and I'd say maybe the Coyotes had one good scoring chance in the first period. But Corey looked good, again, position-wise, and then the second period. All the brouhaha with Alex Edler hitting Mike Smith and the five-minute major, and Corey then settled in and had to make some great saves. I couldn't believe that Marty Hanzel had a breakaway in the last 2 minutes. And yet, Corey again, Radim Verbata. And I think you get this when the players get a little tired and when you kill off a major penalty, especially the defenseman. And Alex Edler's in the box for the 5 minutes. Those other guys were out there. They got a little tired. And I think you could see that in the third period. And Corey bailed them out. And it's one of those things. How many times has the goaltender been a star for the Canucks over the past month? Well, the last couple of games. Yeah. And Corey was picked first star here in the building by the Coyotes press, which is something.
Okay, so it's back-to-back games on the weekend. Do we just assume it's Schneider in L.A. on Saturday and then Luongo the next night in Denver? Or is that up in the air? What do you think?
Well, I would assume that Corey just keeps going and then Roberto gets that game in the back-to-back situation. You have to remember that the Canucks are right back at it again Tuesday. It's right. Not like before where you get that extra day off, so you have to make sure that both goalies get involved.
It's a busy time, and the Canucks likely to be fatigued, but happy to bank 2 points here in a tough one. They slogged out over the Phoenix Coyotes. 2-1 the final for Vancouver. Let's head back to the desk.
Thanks, John. And John, Canucks in L.A. Saturday, Canucks in Colorado Sunday, both games on Sportsnet with Gary and I and the whole gang. All right, Gary, we saw there Jordan Schrader being interviewed, and all these injuries, the so-called lesser lights had to come through, and he was one of them.
Well, he was. He played over 15 minutes, had a great game against St. Louis the other night with a tremendous pass over to Dale Weiss on his goal. Mm-hmm. Getting confidence when you see the little guys button hooking, stopping it up, using the seams, passing the puck well. That means they're confident. Kim going back to Chicago, I felt for a few games, helped him in that. And you look at his goal. Yeah, it's a big goal for a guy like Jordan Schrader. He's had a bunch of chances. But it starts with great D. And Kevin Bieksa here provides just great, smart defense. And then he jumps up and he goes shot. You know, look, this is a lucky break. This is the one that Schrader just missed on.
Yeah.
Then he spins around, to the point, on net.
Goes to the dirty areas.
Scores. But look, Jordan Schrader has to be a big part of this team. He can provide a ton of speed for this team that at times needs it. Played great the last two games, for sure.
You see a right-handed defenseman come up with a big defensive play on the Schrader goal, and it was a right-handed defenseman who came up big on the Chris Tanev goal. That right-handed defenseman is Chris Tanev.
Yeah, you know, on that play was just a tremendous, like you were saying, lacrosse. He could have got a goal and an assist on the same play because he started the play as well. Chris Tanev is a very good skater. Kind of starts with Mason Raymond, made a good D play on this shift as well. On the back check, tremendous back check pressure. This is the same type of play that leads to the goal. Look, Tanev started it from behind the net, passes it up, goes to the slot. Bang, it's in there. What I like about the two goals today are they started with tremendous D plays. Mm. And when you're playing hockey with an injured team, a depleted team, you want to keep the game simple, it sure makes it nicer. You start with defense first. And you could see in this game they did that a lot better tonight than they did against St. Louis the other night.
Yeah, and I said it was Tanev who made the defensive play. He's the one who made the pass up ice. It was Raymond who made the defensive play. And he got the assist. Very quickly, we're running out of time in this particular segment, but the boys were talking about at the end of their segment, Corey Schneider, does he get another start on Saturday?
He does for sure. He should get, you know, he's in good shape for sure. I think he should. He'll play that game. I mean, it's a great game against the team that won the Stanley Cup. Yep. Give that start to Schneider. And he deserved it. Look, he had close to 35 saves again. He had 31 saves in this game. Not a lot of saves early, Donnie, but third period stuff again. He just comes up with so many big saves when the team needs them. And no bad goals are going in on him right now, which is something that hasn't been the case for in Canuck goaltending for the last month or so.
You always talk about this, but you can tell when Corey Schneider's playing well, and that's his legwork is exceptional.
Unbelievably strength. Unreal strong. And he works hard in there.
2-1 for the Vancouver Canucks over the Phoenix Coyotes.